is the economic effects on people. So we first examined this by looking at who lost work and income in Lancaster County. So in our fall survey, we asked people, at any point since March 2020, did anyone in your household lose work? And 38% of the respondents said yes. So 38% of households reported some sort of job loss. Now, the most common type of job loss reported was being laid off temporarily, but without pay or benefits. So as you can imagine, this has an effect on household income. The second most common was having hours reduced. And of this 38% that reported losing work, about 1 in 6 of those were permanent layoffs. Another concern we have with the pandemic is whether its economic effects are distributed unevenly. This is something I'm sure you've all also thought about. Are certain groups more vulnerable to economic hardship due to the pandemic? And so one thing that we did to look at this was to look at whether loss of work occurred at different rates in different groups. So as you see in this slide, Latinx respondents, that's the bar on the right, they have a star because they're significantly more likely to have had someone in their household lose work. You can see more than half of the Latinx respondents to this survey reported that someone in their household had had some level of losing work. That is significantly higher than on the bar on the left is the non-Latinx white respondents. They still had over 35% reporting someone in their household had lost work.
So in the survey, when we did it in 2020, we first asked them how much financial strain they felt in paying rent and mortgage prior to COVID-19. And then we asked them again, how much are they feeling? How much financial strain are they feeling right now? And that in 2020, that was in between September and November. And as Dr. Cox mentioned in the introduction, we actually trace a subset of those respondents in 2021 between March and April. So within this subset of respondents, we asked them again in 2021, how you're feeling now about the level of the financial strain in paying rent and mortgage. So overall, we have about 314 respondents who actually answer the housing question, you know, all throughout like 2020 and 2021. And so what you're seeing here in the bar graph is that there's two bars. The light blue bar shows you the comparison of their financial strain level prior to COVID and then after COVID happened. So what you see here is that about 84% of the household actually feel like it's okay, it remains the same level of financial burden for us. But there were about 10% of almost 11% of the household feel they're more financially strained in paying rent and mortgage after COVID started.
The title is Stress and Mental Health, but I'm going to be speaking particularly about stress. So for this particular study, we focused on stress and not necessarily trying to measure the burden of mental health disorders, because some literature actually shows that stress is consistently related to mental health. And so it was our idea that if we measure stress, it might be a better indicator for our community organizations that offer services for mental health disorders, because now they know what the level of stress is. And if stress is consistently associated with mental health and precedes mental health, then it allows for them, for planning purposes, to try and envision what might be coming in the future.